And on that note, we cue the music.
YouTubers, it's me, Gary, and my neck hurts. Oh, wait, no, it's me, Gary.
Hello out in YouTube land, it's me, Gary, and...
That's me again,
Nick. That's Nick. We are the Thor and Loki of Bill's books. Actually...
I'm going with Beta Ray Bill.
He's going to be Beta Ray Bill, and I'm going to be Thunderstrike. Where is my sweet sleeveless leather jacket?
No, you got one.
That'd be sweet. Anyway, if I had one, I'd wear it today. Let's get into the new books, shall we?
Because there's a few.
There's a lot. We got Marceline... And the Scream Queens. Everybody loves it.
Everyone loves Adventure Time.
Everybody loves Adventure Time. And
I well, still also...
Oh yeah, we get the Adventure Time
Adventure
trade
Time
paper.
Trade, which actually came out last week, but we didn't get it till this week.
Yeah. All-new X-Men number one. Stuart Immonen's art, Brian Bendis' writing.
I wasn't going to go there.
I was trying not to.
Scotty Young cover yeah. got me there, and...
Pleasantly surprised.
I was actually... It was a good story.
Yeah, I liked it. So, Amy Comey Girls... Jimmy Palmiotti, Justin Gray. Enough said. Enough said. What else are we going to say? Final issue of The Boys, where everybody's flying down the toilet.
The Boys are not back in town.
Yes, they are back at the Super Bowl. We are taking the Boys to the Super Bowl. That's, they're following my life, is what they're doing. Chasing the Dead, number one.
I picked that up. Haven't read it yet, though.
I don't know what it is, but there you go.
Looked interesting.
Conan was really good. I can vouch for that.
See who's on the art, too. That's why.
Yeah, that's right. Declan Shalvey.
Great art.
Stuff. Yeah, I love his stuff. Fantastic Four, number one. Now! I'm gonna just keep doing that for now. Now! Every time a new Now book comes out. So, Fantastic Four, number one. Now! Also, one of my favorite issues of the week, Frankenstein, Agent of Shade. Really great. In this one, Velcoro, the vampire, makes like Deadpool and yip-yip-yip-yip-yaps through the whole thing. It's very fun.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, so it's very good stuff.
Again, I hate to say I haven't read most of my books. I haven't even finished last week because of the shows this past weekend.
Yeah, Nick has been a busy little beaver. Indie Horror Comics. Love that. 48 pages.
For just $3.99, I think.
Just $3.99?
$4.75. Oh, my bad.
You liar. Great Crime book came out this week. Issue 2, Point of Impact. If you can find it, pick it up.
Oh, yeah, it's good stuff.
Yeah, it's good stuff. Jay Farber. Corey Curunel, or something.
Anyway, way to pronounce it.
Thomas Kincaid, I think, is the artist. Punk Rock Jesus.
Love that book.
Yeah, so we got that. Let's see, what else do we have here? My bald spot. Oh, the victories. If I pass over the victories, Nick will beat me severely after the video's over.
And, you know, we...
And not in a good way. What?
You got to pay extra for that. But I don't know if people also know that... In the new issue of New Avengers.
Oh, yes, Michael.
What is that? Is it? That's Omen art.
Yep, so it's very good.
There you go.
Yeah. Anytime you get a chance to look at Michael Avon Oming's art, do it. Atomic Robo.
Love that series.
Cult favorite. Everybody loves it. Avengers Assemble.
It's the new creative team there.
Yeah. You know how hard it is for me to not get this in single issues? It's killing me. It's killing me.
So make sure everybody, you in the comments, you put spoilers galore.
Just spoil the shit out of it. Anyway, let's see what else we have here. The Creep was also very good.
I enjoy that.
Yeah, I liked it. It's a really good book. Really good art. I like it a lot. Deathstroke, the art is finally palatable. So
it looks like he's wearing a uniform again and not a unitard.
What you call me?
Nothing that your mom has.
Yeah, that's true. Gambit, that was good. Good art in this, too. Continually good art. Great Pacific, number one. It's not as good as the New York Comic Con exclusive one that we got.
No.
But we got Great Pacific, number one. Is that Road Pig? Road Pig on the cover of G.I. Joe.
Oh, they're dipping back, man.
Oh, they are dipping way back. Next, it'll be Scarface. Remember Scarface from the original run of G.I. Joe?
Oh, yeah.
I love that character.
As you can see, some empty spots there.
Yeah, right.
We got Peter Panzerfaust gone.
We lost our Peter.
We lost our Peter. Saga gone.
Where is Jake Ellis?
Looking forward to that. Nathan Edmondson.
This is one of Nick's picks of the week.
Oh, yeah. If you guys don't know that, go pick up the trade for who is Jake Ellis.
Yeah.
Then you're going to ask, where is Jake Ellis?
My favorite mother killer. X-Men number one.
He is a mother.
Is this X-Men Marvel now?
It's X-Men Legacy now. Now!
X-Men Legacy now! Serenity now!
And there was... let's show him the other now book. Oh, wait a minute.
What?
What? What's this? Someone missed it on the order sheet.
Boy, not now, but Marvel soon!
Yeah.
Let's see what else we have here. More Batman and Robin. He's holding the gag teeth. How about that?
That one's a Deceiver cover. It's not even part of the death, but it looked like it. So everyone thought it was.
That's how they get you. That is how they get you. Grifters. How do you feel about this?
I love that book.
He loves He-Man. He's a He-Man guy.
I grew up on He-Man.
Sure.
My brother was a Joe man. I was a He-Man guy.
I was mostly Joe, but a little He-Man. Wait, what?
What?
It's starting to sound like some kind of Craigslist ad. Mind management, probably the issue of the week for me.
It's the zero?
Yeah, it's the zero issue.
Jump on, people.
Reprints three short stories that appeared digitally, if I'm not mistaken. We already talked about the new Avengers.
Slip by a couple here.
All Evil Ernie.
Evil Ernie issue two.
Yes, and Ex-Sanguine. What'd you call me?
Yeah, that's right. Nothing. I mean, come on. It's a vampire and a serial killer hanging out.
Nice. That should be us.
Yeah.
Tarzan, Once in Future. This looks very pulpy, very Mike Grell, John Sable freelance kind of.
Yeah, I read that.
I thumbed through it.
Read that in the Dark Horse Presents because that's what that collects. The stories in there, and Tarzan, it was really good.
The Tommy Gun.
It's like a futuristic after a cataclysm type Tarzan.
Nice, Thief of Thieves. Excellent. And of course, we have to show this.
The book that'll be the scalpers of the week.
Yeah. Speaking of Thor and Loki, speaking of my bald spot, here's Thor, Loki, Captain Action.
That's right, if you've got the Captain Action doll, you can now have a Thor or a Loki doll.
With a bearded variant there. Oh. That way you don't have to use your Barbie doll to be Thor anymore. Thor's like a Barbie doll, he's so pretty. let's see what else is not right. Yeah.
What else came?
We got some great things, great Christmas gifts for the pervert in your life. We've got
Harley Quinn,
and Wonder Woman and her Wonder Knuckle.
And we also got the Justice League Wonder Woman figure.
Yes.
Which they tried to tell us they raised the price on, but we didn't.
Yeah. We don't listen to them.
No.
And we've got the ultimate figure, probably the best and biggest figure we've had since the Titan Joker. From the Arkham City collection, is the new Darkseid that is supposed to go with the Justice League figures that have been coming out.
As you can tell,
Homeboy is...
There's one... It'd take two Wonder Woman to be the size of Darkseid.
Yeah, so...
That's a lot of figure.
Yeah, so we got that. We also got a couple of cool big books this week. Fables, hardcover, Werewolves of the Heartland. How do you feel about it, Nick?
Oh, I love Fables. Been there since the beginning.
He's a Fables guy from way back.
I have that.
One of my favorite art books, Naughty and Nice by Bruce Timm. It's not for your kids.
No, it's not.
It's for when you have a little alone time. You can look at that.
That's the pocket version, they call it, because the other one was oversized.
Should I make a joke about going from pocket size?
I think the joke is made naturally.
Yeah. You can all just make your own joke.
Yeah.
Word it however you want to. Scene of the Crime, trade paperback, Ed Brubaker, Michael hardcover. Lark. Oh, yeah. Hardcover. Michael Lark, Sean Phillips. This is good crime comics, kids.
Come on, people. If you're buying Fatal, if you're buying Thief of Thieves, if you're buying Criminal.
Anything you buy, you should be buying this.
You should be.
With a foreword by Brian Bendis about how he's jealous of Ed Brubaker being able to write crime comics so well.
As well.
Yeah. So if you're a crime comics fan, buy that. If you're buying Stumptown, anything.
Yeah.
Torpedo. I love the art of Jordy Bernay. Let's leaf through it real quick, just so you can see what it's like.
That's just incredible. I keep kicking this one around.
Yeah, because he did a lot of work on Jonah Hex. which is why we like it.
Good stuff.
We also have the Jim Silk sketchbook.
Don't flip.
Don't flip?
No.
Okay, I won't flip.
A little dot-oriented on a couple of those, so...
Okay, so now we want to talk about the great and successful Akron ComiCon that we went to. The interwebs are abuzz with the success, especially for a first-year convention. Everything went off very smoothly. We had we met Jerry Conway, who was the co-creator of The Punisher and Firestorm. Super nice guy. We also met Joe Staten. Staten? Is it Staten or Staten? Anyway, he was there. He designed the cover for the... if I can find it. The cover for the...
It's a good thing you're organized.
Yeah, it's a good thing I knew we were shooting a video today. Anyway. I don't know. Anyway, he designed the cover for the program, and I got it autographed, and I wanted to show it to you.
It's in your bag over there.
Is it in my bag?
Yeah.
Wait, Anyway. Sorry. Anyway, I just wanted to show you, and now it's going to be anticlimactic, but he has the nicest autograph of anybody I've ever seen in my life.
You could actually tell who
Yeah, you can actually. And I told him, this is the nicest autograph I've ever seen, and he said, thank you. Next. No, but he did this cover, and I love Guy Gardner, so I had him sign that.
Moon Boots.
Yes, so we saw those three. Oh, I went to a panel. Mike May, Hollywood prop guru. He worked on Jaws. He worked on Star Trek. He worked on a lot of stuff. He told some great anecdotes about life as a Hollywood prop guru, set designer guru. So that was really cool.
You think you can get guru in there one more time?
Guru. We also saw some of our friends here from Bill's Books, Chris Yambar, Dan Gorman, both guys who have been to the store and done some great art for us and had some great signings for us. Marvel artist Joe Miller was there. Let's see, what else do we have? Oh, Bill found this sweet, sweet Joker figure for me. So that's what it's like to work for Bill. He's always looking out for you.
Knock it out of your hand.
You are not going to knock this out of my hand. Don't be like that. I also got 6 issues closer to completing my Master of Kung Fu run. So I'm very excited, from the dollar box. Look, now explain this to me. This one says Death Wears Three Faces, and that's issue 54. You go to issue 63, and Doom wears three faces.
Death and Doom, man.
Yeah, it's a... Did they run out of things to say on the cover of the comic book?
Taxes only wears two.
Apparently one of Doom's faces is Hammerhead in drag. So what else do we have here? This one, issue 59, must have the X-Men in it because it's got the Phoenix Gambit and the Angel of Doom. So like 3 X-Men are going to be in that, apparently. So there's Doom Wears Three Faces. That is a sweet, sweet cover.
Oh, yeah.
Paul Gillespie, excellent. Shang-Chi must choose the Lady or the Tiger, and either way it's death. It looks like they busted in on him and they were getting funky. So, and then we got this, the impossible I'm standing on one tiptoe and kicking, hyper-extending so far that...
Well, that's what the Master of Kung Fu does.
Yeah, see, if he wasn't the Master of Kung Fu, he couldn't do that.
No.
So I did that. Another thing that happened is I was going to get a sketch from Josh Medors. And Josh Medors, he's a great artist. He got sick and went into the hospital. He's got cancer, and he's in and out of the hospital. So I was kind of bummed out. I wasn't, you know, going to get a sketch from him. Not that that was all I was worried about. I was worried about his health, obviously, too. But Sean Forney, a friend of his, who is also an artist, came up to the convention, and he had a special. If you buy Josh's sketchbook for $10, he would give you his sketchbook for $5 plus a free print. So I took advantage of that. So I have here... the Sean Forney sketchbook, which you should definitely check out, and the Josh Medors sketchbook. This guy's art is ridiculous. I mean, look how good it is.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So you should definitely, if you can, I guess he's, I guess Sean is doing something for Help for Heroes, I think it's called, and we'll put the right information in the description. But so if you want to go on and buy some Josh Medors stuff, Medors, you should definitely check that out. It would help to defray the medical costs. And Sean Forney is doing a lot of good stuff for his friend Josh. So we should all pitch in and help, you know, cheer this guy up because he's sick in the hospital. So I got my free print with my Sean Forney, Josh Medors sketchbooks. I got a sweet, sweet Sean Forney werewolf print. Anybody that knows me loves that, knows I love werewolves. The only thing that would make this better if he was a ninja werewolf.
It's hair envy, isn't it?
It's hair envy. I think that could be it. That's why you like werewolves. It's also why I get mad at Bill's back. Anyway, I also got a sketch from Sean Forney.
You're getting fired.
I'm so getting fired. Sorry, folks. It's been fun. So we got a Sean Forney sweet, sweet Daredevil sketch.
Nice.
And we also got Andrew Bennett, who's done a sketch for me before, did this god-awesome Solomon Kane sketch, which I love. And wait for it.
And how can you go a show without Daryl Banks and not get...
How can
get...
you not get a Daryl Banks Shang-Chi Master of Kung Fu sketch? Oh, my God.
He's wiggling his toes at you.
Oh, it's adorable, isn't it? Anyway, so we had a lot of fun. We saw a lot of people we knew. I had another YouTube faithful come and say hi to me. Her name is Leah Berg. I love it when women come up and say hello to me because they recognize me from something. So let's keep that happening, shall we? So anyway, thank you very much. And let's see what else. Let's talk about the... congratulations to Mike Savine, by the way, for putting on such a successful show.
Yeah.
Mike and the boys really did a good job, and we loved it, and we'll be back next year. We got some Black Friday sales coming up. We're in the midst of making them up, so I'm just going to give you kind of a preview because it's really the best I can do. So follow me over here, and I'll show you what Bill's got written down for me.
We're staggering it over the entire weekend.
Yes. We're not going to have a Black Friday sale. We're going to have a Black Weekend sale.
Wait, what?
Wait. Anyway, Friday, 50% off trades and hardcovers.
Select trades and hardcovers.
Select trades and hardcovers, and Nick will select them.
Yes.
All our dollar books will be 75 cents. We're going to do the sale where everything that's $10 and under is a buck, and everything that's $11 and up is 50% off. So that's all of our binned back issues.
Yeah.
So
that does not include Silver Age or the separate. It's the stuff that's in the regular bins.
That's our legal department, Nick. Yeah. Saturday, $5 and $10 trades and hardcovers.
Again, those will be
selected. And Nick will select them. And our dollar books will be 50 cents.
Oh.
Yes. And Sunday, 50% off Silver Age and Wall Stock.
Which Bill will select.
Which Bill will select. And our books will be our dollar books will be 25 cents, and you can build a box, which I assume is a long box,
yep,
for $50. So definitely come down, check out. Also, we're going to have Dan Gorman in the house.
On Friday, I think.
On Friday, and possibly Saturday. We might also have some other artists, so I don't know what all is going on, but definitely come down and check out the Black Friday sale. We'll be in here for all your Christmas shopping nerd needs. So until next week... Keep your feet in the peanut butter jar and keep reaching for the plunger. Happy Thanksgiving.
Don't OD on turkey.